Welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray, brought to you proudly by Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency, Barton Power Sports, Sportsman's Warehouse, and Best Care Home Services.
Good Saturday morning, and welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray, where we would like to thank all of the men and women who are serving our country in the armed forces. Veterans Day coming up tomorrow and observed on Monday. And here he is, the host with the most, Larry Ray.
I love that host with the most. You know, can you ask the folks at DU to make me a shirt? Ducks Unlimited, the host with the most.
Host with the most. I can definitely look into that.
We need to copyright that.
We should.
We could have the co-host with the most.
An official
co-host with the most.
DU licensed product, the Larry Ray host with the most shirt.
Hey, we walked in here this morning, and right away John grabbed this little yellow box I have here. It says Hunt to Go Clean Shot Shoot Through Gun Bore Cleaners. Cleaner, and as I said, his fingerprints are all over the box, and we got the man on with us that was on previously on Outdoors with Larry Ray, and talk about clean shot, because it's something that kind of blows my mind on the development of this product and where it is and where this guy has come from, a marketing guy from Michigan. Comes up with the idea, and we've got Kurt Whitworth on us from Hunt to Go Limited. Good morning, Kurt.
Hey, Larry. How are you?
We are doing wonderful, and we love to talk products. And, you know, I know this product well because of our talk before, but bring us up to date because, you know, I've had the 12-gauge. And, folks, all you do, explain Clean Shot to our listeners out there.
It's a simple use product. You go out, you shoot trap, you shoot skeet. Let's say you're out duck or geese hunting. Bottom line is, when you're done with your day, simply load like a 12 gauge round or a 20 gauge round, pull the trigger. The device is designed to the way it works is as it goes down the barrel, the device collapses. It has an outward pressure. It scrubs the bore, traps the particles, and sends them down range. It's really as simple as pulling the trigger. I mean, you clean your gun in like a 400th of a second.
Wow. It's amazing.
Literally.
And it looks like a shotgun shell.
Oh, it does. You wouldn't be able to tell. Of course, it's clear, but other than that, it just is a normal 12-gauge shell.
Yeah, and I'm looking at it here.
I will say it shoots like a shotgun shell. You know, it has a muzzle velocity of 1,050 feet per second. It's got a breach pressure of about 10,000 psi, like I'll say 96 to 10,000 psi for the 12 gauge. So it shoots. So this is true ammunition. You know, it's an ammunition product. So take all the precautions needed. But here's one thing I say is it's a simple and easy and cost effective way to field clean your gun while you're in the field. So I go out and shoot all day. I shoot a clean, you know, I have an over-under. So I shoot, you know, two rounds through. I take my gun. I put it in the case. I jump in the truck. I drive home. My wife is waiting for me. We go out to dinner. I don't have to go to the garage and spend 45 minutes bench cleaning my gun. I do bench clean my gun about every 6 months.
Okay.
because that's all I have to. I mean, there's, you know, what used to take me 40 minutes, I do now do in like 8.
And you're telling me, I know that this all, you saw this product in your head. I mean.
You remember that.
Oh, I remember that. Who would forget that? I see a lot of products in my head, you know, but to fulfill it, it's got to be a satisfaction to you. And tell our listeners how you came up with this idea.
You know, it's one of those rare times. And at the time, you know, I used to carry a binder with me, and if I had an idea, I'd write it down so it just didn't get trapped in my head. So which kind of sounds crazy, but as I was working through something, I saw the idea, I drew it up, I started looking for it, I couldn't find it, I started reading patents. I've probably read 2,000 patents now. Wow. Where you start really digging in, and you're really deep diving the internet, and I couldn't find anything. So I applied for a provisional. I began proving the product out on my kitchen table. I'm the guy up at 2:30 in the morning, 3 o'clock, like cutting up pieces and taking measurements.
Amazing,
you know.
Yeah.
And so you engineer your first product and you fail. and then you re-engineer and you fail, and you keep re-engineering until you begin producing the results. And I understood what was happening, so
yeah.
Taught myself how to hand load. And bottom line is, next thing you know, I'm going to the range every other day, testing until I proved the model out. And then I knew at that point I was onto something.
Yes.
And really, what I'll say is, it just became an addiction, and I just couldn't give it up. I was just totally attached to the idea, and now it's what I do all day, every day.
And we're talking to Kurt Whitworth of Hunt to Go Limited, Clean Shot, and I know. I have to admit, and I think I mentioned this before, that not too many years ago, I had a friend whose ashes was put in a shotgun shell and loaded and was shot. And
right.
There's been some crazy things done with shotgun shells, but this is a thing that works. This is not something that was that happened last year. He has worked on this for many years. This man has even got this in Walmart, folks. Now, that's a chore in itself right there, since Walmart doesn't sell ammunition, but they do sell the Clean Shot.
They do. So we presented to Walmart, had an opportunity for a five-minute presentation.
A five-minute preparatory? What now? Hold on. You had to do a five-minute presentation to get it in Walmart? Is that they had a time limit?
No. we had an opportunity for a five-minute presentation,
uh-huh.
And when we presented, we ended up being there like an hour and a half. It was like, I'll give you 5 minutes. It better be good. And we went from there to 3,726 locations nationwide, and now we have a permanent spot on the shelf. We have a 20 gauge and 12 gauge.
The 20 gauge is new, right? I mean, I didn't want to interrupt you, but a lot of folks just think the 12 gauge, but you do have a 20 gauge now, right?
Yeah, 20 gauge came out like week 30, so that was like September
of last
September
year. This past 16th, September?
No, of this year. Yeah,
this year. Now, okay.
Yep.
All right. So the 20 yep. gauge is out there too, and I look at this. I know this is not something that you spend a lot of time in advertising. I think you told me that you saw this thing you hit, as I mentioned earlier, like this. Are you amazed at what's happened on this, Kurt?
You know, it's. I think it's the chase, right? It's like you're trying to make people aware of it. Here's a battle. It's like we're a new company,
yeah.
Introducing a new technology to an old industry. Right. So there's a lot of guys out there who say the only way I can clean my gun is with a ramrod brush.
They don't believe that. That's right. Yeah. Yeah.
They don't. Right. And so those are the guys that they have a hard time convincing. But I think when we show it to them, they go, wow. Like,
that's what I did. That's what I did. I took it to the gun club. We have a really nice gun club here, and people did not believe it when I shot it out there. And they wanted to do it again. I said, well, I can't. My gun's already clean now. You know, why do I want to shoot it again? You know, it's already like that. And you look at if I'm not mistaken, again, this aspect has a chance to even, let's say, what if the military have the chance to use some of this, right?
Yeah. So I will say this.
What?
While all of this stuff happens every day and it's a lot to do.
Yeah.
I can't stop the process, so no. I started going down the road for a 9mm.
Uh-huh, yeah.
So I took one of our we're 9 patents deep in this, so I took one of our patents and broke up that into a 9mm and had some parts ground down and began shooting prototypes. So I think with a 9mm, I'm probably 50 to 65, maybe 70% there. We've got some hurdles ahead of us, but it's my plan to release the 9mm in 2019.
Wow. I've got to ask you this because this is just dumb me. You know that and everything. When you go to a high school reunion, the people ask you, what are you doing now, Kurt?
I don't know. See, what happens, you guys get me all fired up, right? So you start talking about it, and I get all excited. I can't help it, right?
That's great,
so,
yeah.
So I just try to say like, oh, I'm in sales or I'm in manufacturing. And then if they start digging deeper, well, then I just can't help it. I just start pouring. It's all good.
Well, let me ask John.
I love talking about it.
Yeah, let me ask John Gordon here, because John has a goose guiding service in Mississippi, is a wonderful waterfowl hunter and everything. When you look at that, John, would you like to have some of those in your blind?
Oh, I guarantee that. That's pretty revolutionary, Kurt. I mean, I know how much of a pain it can be to take the barrel off of shotguns, that they're, have to clean it out and everything. And you really need to, because, and all the shots that you take with all the powder fouling and the wadding and everything like that, it really builds up and it affects the patterns. People don't really realize that.
It does.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
And dirt,
so,
when you're out there in the
elements. And the weather. The elements and things along that.
Right. So that'd be great just to be able to, pull the trigger one more time and your barrel's clean. Like you said, you head on home.
I think if you have like a ported barrel, what happens is when you're shooting your normal rounds to, for your hunting, whatever, the plastic of the wads is being forced outward, because of the acceleration and, those BBs are being shoved down in the cup and it's just pushing out. Well, it gets caught on all those portings. And if you take a bore scope, a recording bore scope, and drag it down through there, there's little plastic cones that come off of that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so when that hardens and binds to your plastic, and then your choke, right? I mean, your choke funnels everything down to a tighter pattern. So when the clean shot's coming through at full velocity, it scrubs that out. It cleans the choke. It does a great job on a choke. I'm surprised. I have guys pulling out the choke all the time, and they're looking through it and they're sharing it with their buddies. And I go, I'm going to tell you one thing. I go, I have not cleaned that choke in 10,000 rounds by hand. I've never cleaned it.
Man.
And the guy goes, you're kidding me. I go, as God is my witness. And he's like, wow, this is great.
Well, I tell you what, Kurt, thank you. Now, if you just sit down and make me an easy way to clean my muzzleloader, I'd really be happy, okay, So
yeah, I'll work on it.
Work on it, Kurt. You got plenty of time. Yeah, right. Hey, Kurt, thank you for being on Outdoors with Larry Ray on this Saturday morning, buddy. We appreciate you. Look forward to getting my box of shells coming in, my clean shot, and we'll stay in touch, and you be sure and thank old Glenn Walker for helping us set up this interview, okay?
All right, will do. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Kurt. Have a great one. All right, let's take a break. That's hard to top that one, but we're going to talk fishing with a guy that I bet that Ron doesn't even know this. This guy's been around a while. He started as a milkman?
Now that I didn't know.
Yes, we'll be right back and talk to Jared Littner. Is that right, John?
Littner.
Be right back on Outdoors with Larry Ray.